नमस्ते फ्रेंड्स वन एंड ऑल इंडिविजुअल्स इन वेरियस डोमेन्स. इन माय टू प्रीवियस वीडियोस आई वाज टॉकिंग अबाउट द एम्प्लॉयबिलिटी द एम्प्लॉयमेंट ऑपर्चुनिटीज दैट कुड बी एक्सप्लोर्ड. Now in this video, let me take this subject to the further extent where I would want to actually like talk in cross reference to Hewlett and Packard inception as a company, how they grew, Apple how they grew, and Microsoft how they grew. If I really look at these three companies, have started with a small garage, with a small space, and they stuck to their guns. When I say guns, I mean thought process, with a distinct vision, with a far-sightedness, irrespective of their status quo. Steve Jobs, college dropout, Gates, school dropout, Hewlett and Packard, though graduates, but still they had their own ideas they could work out. In Indian companies, Oyo, they are IITians, however they had that extra mileage of becoming IITians. That's a different aspect altogether. डब्बा वाला who became famous for his tiffins and other things, who had that distinct image and he had that distinct vision where he wanted to establish himself. He was not having any formal education. He started with the very initial thing, in fact. And the point over here is, if I really take Steve Jobs, Bill Gates, Hewlett and Packard, they were from the foreign land, still they had those ideas and they could develop. When we come to the Indian companies, India was not so very developed, but still Dabbawala had that guts, patience and things to do. He could become a change. He was benefactor for the change. Similarly, in art and culture, Dr. Vempati Chinnasathya Master Garu, late Dr. Vempati Chinnasathya Master Garu, he was a change. he created that change. He had that distinct vision to look at things in a very different way. Sarvepalli Radhakrishna, though he was holding presidential post, but still he wanted to propagate education and he never lost his foot. Kalam sir gave away all his wealth, all his savings, all his everything, whatnot, and dedicated himself as a person by distributing his knowledge to the students, to the poorest. Haldar Nag, he was a third class. He didn't have any formal education, but still, with his prose and poetry, he had created that spiritual renaissance or philosophical renaissance, creating that awareness in the society. Now, what is it that one can learn from them? From the business point of view, if we really look at the Dabbawala concept from Mumbai, he was very unique with his own subjective and he was very objective with his approach. He never thought, fine, I'm not getting it, let me not look at it. But he continued his journey. Likewise, Fevicol CEO, ये Fevicol का जोड़ है. He had his own pitfalls. And all of these have come from the phase what exactly the current students are coming out. Am I correct? Ratan Tata. He didn't forget his footage. Ambani started his career from petrol bunk. Like this, if I take, there are many examples. Ramadasu, Bhakta Ramadasu, he was jailed. I had been to that jail. I had seen that, how exactly the food was given. It was given from this point, from a hole. I don't know what kind of food they might have given to him. What is that one difference or one line, one silver line that divides between these people and we as individuals? Are lacking. These people were also very much common people, common individual in a society. Five major areas wherein they have touched. One is guts to face the reality. Second is depending on natural intelligence, natural thought process, acceptance of the truth, common goal point, common goal cast, firmness in their goal cast and aim cast. forget about the money part. They didn't have the money. All of these people didn't have enough money. I know in Vizag there is one person. That pawn shop name is Graduate Pawn Shop near the Jilla Parishad. He was a graduate. He didn't get a job. But he is making a big business. Late Dr. Vempati Chinnasathyam Master Garu. He had a distinct vision, a positive vision, a firm vision, a strong vision, a strong goal cast, a strong aim cast. And he stuck to that till the very last. He didn't have the money or whatever it is. The only message that I am giving to the current students or the current society is that even this is for the parents. This is for the individuals who think that someone who is trying his ideas and all, if he or she is failing, don't try to downtrod him. Don't try to downsize him. Try to understand and see what are his ideologies, his or her ideologies, and see what best you can do to pump up his or her attitude towards growing. And as a teacher, what is it that you are giving? This specifically holds good in art and culture, specifically fine arts and culture, because the knowledge transfer pertaining to anything starts with philosophy and spirituality. Philosophy and spirituality are the two pillars which are by default imbibed in the art and culture. Because unless and until you know the basic philosophy, phenomena behind whatever that you are doing when you are performing as fine arts is what matters. The spirituality aspect automatically starts developing as he or she grows, because this is one of the starting point for an individual. To learn classical dance as a part of aim and hobby is one part of it. To learn classical art form from the yoga point of view is one aspect. From the philosophy point of view is one aspect. From the spirituality point of view is one aspect. All of these culminating, engulfing all of these aspects make it divine in nature. Though the same thing is taught to the individuals by the teacher at school level and institutional level. So, here the primary emphasis for the schools, colleges, institutions, research institutions, R&D development institutions, scientific analytical institutions, medical institutions need to really think on philosophy and the spirituality aspect and the phenomena of the old Indian culture. Now, one may ask as to why I am talking about this. If I take Steve Jobs, Bill Gates, Dabbawala, Ratan Tata, Fevicol CEO, like this if I name, all of these individuals knew the phenomena, philosophy, spirituality and the other aspects by default. They didn't run around money. They didn't think about the name and fame. But what they thought was, let's try doing this small piece of job by helping the society. And most of the startups or the most of the entrepreneurs, if I really look at, they miss on these points first. Because these pillars, if they are missing, if the base itself is going wrong, it is not strong. Definitely, it will not grow. Now, most of the individuals or most of us are depending on on the virus attacks antibiotic. For starting something or doing something. And we are thinking we do not have that, we do not have those resources with us. Let's try understanding from the logical point of view and the philosophical and spiritual point of view. From the philosophy and spiritual point of view, if you really see, if you take, if as an individual you take your own time out and start thinking, what is it that I have to really do something of my own? This is the situation wherein you can really think about it. Because this time really will not come. This is an ideal platform for everyone to understand. Be it any domain. That is one point. Second point, as I said, let's take, I as an individual, I am 45 now. And I am not getting a job. I know that getting a job is difficult in this pandemic attack situation. Even the pre-pandemic attack situation, it was the same. And I did not have any opportunity as such. I wanted to explore, but still I was not getting it. I didn't really concentrate on what are my strengths and weaknesses, sir. I was like thinking, I will get a job going to interviews, these interviews, that interviews and all. But one day when I started recording, when I started talking about various aspects and various phases, today the videos have come to 190. Now I understood what my strengths and what my weaknesses are all about. How can I nurture? In fact, even Steve Jobs, when he put up his company, before even putting his company, when he was doing his education, he was a literally utter failure, he thought. He thought he was not doing justice to what he wanted to. So So once he was sitting silent, he went to a spiritual guru and a philosophical guru. He learned the art of understanding the science of silence and the science of sound, inner sound within himself. And he started thinking, what is it that I can do? Then he got that confidence and he did that. Similarly, Bill Gates. Even Albert Einstein, before he was looking at E is equal to mc square equation, he had to understand the philosophy, phenomena, and the spirituality aspect of the universal existence as a whole. There also spirituality and philosophy is coming. So what do you think? This is the greatness of spirituality, philosophy, and the phenomena of Hinduism culture. The point is, Hinduism, the true definition of Hinduism is understanding the phenomena or the philosophy and the spirituality aspect of whatever that is happening, which has been told long time back in Indic and Indus Valley civilization, Harappa, Mohenjo-daro, and centuries passed away and things passed away. Today is 21st century and we as individuals are thinking that technological advancement is what actually matters and this is what is the thing, that's it. But pillars for this are phenomena, philosophy, and spirituality of existence and coexistence. One may ask, as a non-performer, as a non-professional dancer, how do I to develop that? How do I to understand this thing? It is not necessary that one needs to learn dance or anything, but understand the gist, summary, or anything from the subjective and objective point of view, and just try to follow. Everything will fall in place. If people are thinking coronavirus is a virus, yes, it is a virus. What kind of virus is it? Yes, it is like some object that they are showing, but logically, coronavirus is the virus that is like immunity factor. When I say immunity factor, it is developed through understanding of the spirituality aspect, and this is where the yoga practice comes into picture. And everything is multidimensional. It has a multidimensional and multi way of thinking. Everything works simultaneously. When you are healthy, when you are healthy and when your mind is pure, filled with purity and impurity are lost in the thought process. And it is not having any negative thinking. That's when you can think positively, you can start your life. Understand this to the deep. Money will automatically come to you. Till yesterday, I was thinking, what is it that if a corona patient who got affected, or he or she is in the primary stages, goes to hospital, does or what a doctor does? Doctors give you the psychological encouragement. They may give you what you call ventilators. And they will be giving you sedatives, tablets, apart from that sanitization. Why sanitization is given that primary importance? Because everything has to be neat and clean. Unless and until you are neat and clean, your mind will not get those pure thoughts. And this is what is taught in spirituality and philosophy. And this is what is taught in art and cultural form, classical dance form. It's not only for entertainment, one needs to understand from this point of view also. One may ask, did Steve Jobs or Bill Gates or Haldar Nag or Sarvepalli Radhakrishna, Kalam sir, follow all of these? Did they understand this core concept of whatever this pandemic attacks symptoms or pandemic attacks antidotes, factors and cofactors were? Yes, they followed first. They understood all of these in depth. And that's when they developed. And it took them a long time to establish themselves. Understand this to the core. The plus point for the 21st century or the current students in the medical advancement or the technological advancement or this time frame is that they have technologies in place, but technologies were not in place during that period of time when all of these people whom I was talking about, they had the phenomena behind philosophy and spirituality through texts or through gurus or through rituals or through practices, discipline, whatnot, everything. Today we have everything. For a startup or for anyone to understand, be it in the business, be it any field, be it any field, believe me, there are only three pillars. Understanding the phenomena behind the actions, philosophy behind the series of incidents that are happening, the spirituality aspect that holds or strengthens. All of these people, maybe there might be a few more, they also had, they followed this. And this is the time wherein fine arts and culture can clash. Professionals who are in fine arts and culture, who are in classical dance form, who know classical dance form, have that edge over all of this if they understand from this point of view and start looking at employability, teaching them the ways to control, set that equanimity between body, mind and soul automatically. The immunity factor will come into place. Thus, I conclude this video with the pointers and cofactors being phenomena, philosophy, and the spirituality aspect of our Vedic and Upanishad structure. I end this video with a positive note. Stay blessed. Have a blissful life. Have a nice day ahead. May the Guru's grace be with you. One and all. Have a nice day.